This is the first of two videos on the topic of birth processes, which corresponds to chapter 3 in the lecture notes. So before we turn to our full generalization of Poisson processes, which will be continuous time Markov chains in the next chapter, we're going to first generalize one aspect of the Poisson process. So suppose we want to model a growing population in continuous time. So if new individuals are born or arrive at a constant rate, then we could just use the Poisson process. If, on the other hand, the birth rate depends on the number of individuals who are present already in the population, then the Poisson process is not going to be a good model. And that motivates the following definition. So let's fix a sequence of parameters lambda n for n in the naturals. So this is going to be a sequence such that every element is finite and is greater than or equal to zero for each n greater than or equal to zero. We're going to fix a starting state somewhere in the naturals, and we're going to let z1, z2, and so on be independent random variables which are exponentially distributed, with zn being exponential with the shifted parameter, so lambda k plus n minus 1 for all n greater than or equal to 1. So then we define the process xt by the following. We're going to start in state k, and then we're going to add on to that the number of values n such that this sum of exponential random variables with different parameters is less than or equal to t. But note that these exponential random variables are independent of one another. So a process which is constructed in this way is called a simple birth process started from the state k. So let's think a little about what's going on here. So x is a counting process, which when it first reaches the state n, waits a length of time which is distributed as exponential lambda n, and then jumps to n plus 1. So here, the parameter lambda n is referring to the fact that we're in state n, rather than that this is the nth jump that we've made, because we started in some general state k. And the word simple here is referring to the fact that no two births are occurring at the same time. So it's going to be useful for the rest of our discussion of birth processes to have in our hands the following proposition. So this is about competing exponentials. So let's let E1, E2, En, and so on be IID this time with the same parameter, so the IID exponential lambda where we have the same parameter lambda, thought of as the times until n alarm clocks ring. Okay, so you've got n alarm clocks, each of them has an exponential lambda time until it rings. So then m, which is defined to be the minimum of those, so that's the time until the first of the alarm clocks rings, has exponential n lambda distribution. And moreover, if we take k to be the index of the first alarm clock that rings, then k is uniformly distributed on 1 up to n, it's equally likely to be each of the alarm clocks, and conditionally on it having been alarm clock number k, then the random variables m and then ej minus m for the other indices are independent. So let's interpret this. So ej minus m is the remaining time until the jth alarm clock rings. Okay. And these random variables are independent and each exponential lambda distributed. Okay, so you can see straightforwardly here that this is going to be a consequence of the memoryless property for the exponential. So a careful proof of this is a special case of a question on problem sheet 1. So I'm going to leave that to you. But we're going to use this proposition in a moment. So section 3.1 is a worked example. This is the prototypical example of a birth process, which is called the Yule process. So let's consider a population in which each individual gives birth after an exponential lambda time, independently and repeatedly. So individuals don't die, they just keep going forever, and every exponential lambda length of time, they give birth. And so in particular, if there are n individuals present at a specific time, then each of them waits an exponential lambda time until it next gives birth. And so in particular, if I'm starting with n people, the first birth is going to occur after an exponential n lambda time, because this is the minimum of n independent exponentials. So in particular, then we have n plus 1 individuals, and by the proposition that we just saw, the process just begins over from the beginning again. We've got the n minus one individuals who didn't reproduce. Those must be each waiting a further exponential lambda time by the proposition. Then there's the individual which did give birth, and that gets a new exponential lambda time until it next gives birth. And then there's the individual who was just born, who of course gets a fresh exponential lambda until it first gives birth. So in particular, the size of the population in this case is performing a simple birth process with rates lambda n equals m lambda. So when we have n individuals present, we have an exponential n lambda time until the next birth. And so, as I said, this is often known as a Yule process. So let's suppose that we start from a single individual, and let's let yt be the number of individuals that are alive at time t greater than zero. So what I'd like to do now is think about how the mean of this process behaves through time. So let's define m of t to be the expectation of yt. So the proposition, which I'm going to prove, says that this m of t, so the mean population size at time t, behaves like e to the lambda t for t greater than or equal to zero. Okay, so how do we prove this? So this is a very important technique in this course. So let's firstly define t, which is going to be the first birth time. So let's let this be the of the times greater than or equal to zero, such that we're starting from y naught equals one. So this is the first time that y is equal to two. Okay, and the thing you should notice is that after the first birth has occurred, we now have two individuals, each of which is behaving like the original individual did. So we can actually think of the population now as being composed of people descending from the first of those individuals and people descending from the second of those individuals. And you can see that each of those is just a little Yule process in its own right. So let's split the expectation. According to whether t has occurred or not. Okay, so we've got n of t, this is the expectation of yt, and I'm going to say that this I can split up as the expectation of yt on the event that the time capital T occurs before little t, plus the expectation of yt on the event that the first birth has not yet occurred. So capital T is bigger than 2. Okay, so we can go a little bit further with this. So let's condition on precisely what the value of t is. So we've got an integral between 0 and t, and let's have the expectation of yt given that capital T equals u. And then we need to integrate over the density of t, which is just an exponential lambda random variable. So it has density lambda e to the minus lambda u du. And then in the second term, well, if the first birth has not yet occurred, then we still have the single individual that we started with. And so in particular, this expectation here is just equal to the probability that t is greater than t, since the yt is always equal to 1 in this situation. So here, this is equal to 1. And so in particular, that whole term is equal to the probability that t is bigger than t. So that's just the tail probability for an exponential lambda distribution. Okay, so we have that once we've had our first birth, so in this situation here, where we know that the first birth is occurring at time t equals u, so then the remaining evolution, so we've got time t minus u left to go, and we've just got two independent Yule processes, we said, because we've got now two individuals, each of which are giving rise to their own little Yule process. So in particular, if t is equal to u, then we have that from time u onwards, this process y u plus s for s greater than or equal to zero evolves as the sum
of two independent copies of the original neural process. So that tells me that expectation of yt given that t equals u, and u here is something which is earlier than little t, so this is equal to 2 times the expectation of the original Yule process, but now run for time t minus u. But of course, that's just the definition of m of t minus u. I get 2m t minus u. So if we insert that back into this equation that we've already got, so let's call this star. The star is equal to the integral between 0 and t of 2 lots of m times t minus u, of course, times the density of our exponential random variable. And then we've got the tail of that exponential random variable, which is just e to the minus lambda t. So perhaps I can get rid of this star and just say that this is equal to m of t.
So this gives us an integral equation for the quantity m of t at different times. And it's easiest to solve this by converting it into a differential equation. And that will be rendered easier if we do first a change of variables in the integral. So let's let s be t minus u. So then changing variable, we get that m of t is equal to, let's bring some things out the front, integral between 0 and t. So I've got now m of s, and then here I get a lambda e to the minus t, and then a lambda e to the, sorry, an e to the lambda s dx. And then I've still got my e to the minus lambda t term. And things will be facilitated by multiplying this equation through by e to the lambda t. So I get e to the lambda t times m of t, which is equal to 2 lambda, the integral between 0 and t of m of s e to the lambda s ds, plus 1 now. Okay, so let's now differentiate both sides of this equation. So that's going to give us, I get a lambda e to the lambda t times m of t plus an e to the lambda t times m prime. And then is differentiating the other side, I get obviously my 2 lambda, I get m of t e to the lambda t, and differentiating the constant 1 gives 0. And so if I rearrange this, I see that I've got lambda e to the lambda t m of t term, which cancels off the right-hand side. I can also cancel the e to the lambda t's because they're non-negative. And so this gives that m prime of t is equal to simply lambda times m of t. Okay, so we also have an initial condition here. We have that the expectation of y naught is simply 1 because we will start with single individual. So m of 0 is equal to 1. And together with that initial condition, you recognize the differential equation, which is simply solved by the exponential function. And that's the unique solution. So this implies that m of 2 is simply e to the lambda 2. That's the end of the proof. So we have a population which, at least in terms of its mean, is growing exponentially. On primitive one, there's a question which will show you that this is true not just in the terms of the mean, but also in an almost sure sense. So let's now turn to the Markov property for a birth process. So in the same way as we saw for the Poisson process that there was a Markov property, this is also true for birth processes in general, and for much the same reason. So proposition. So let's let X be a simple birth process with, as before, this sequence of rates lambda n for n greater than or equal to 0, started again from some state k, x0 equals k. So let's fix a time and a second state, I, which is greater than or equal to k. So then given that at time t we're in state I, the process
up until time t and the process from time t onwards are conditionally independent, and the conditional distribution of the process from time t onwards is that of a simple birth process with the same rates, but simply now started from I rather than from k. And the proof of this proposition proceeds in exactly the same way as for Poisson processes, where you just replace lambda by lambda n for the appropriate n. So I'm not going to go through that again, and I'll leave you to fill in the details.